My name is Leo Kirsch and you are watching Dental Academy USA. Thank you for tuning in. In this channel, we talk a lot about how you can become a dentist in the United States. Today's video is a video that people have no clue about how much certain parts of the application can help you or hurt you if you don't know what you're doing. And today we're going to be talking about the letter of recommendation, a major mistake that I see people doing when they get the letter of recommendation, how to avoid this. But you've been following me for a while. I know you know this. You have to go ahead and subscribe to the channel, leave a comment, like the video, suggestion for next video. Make sure you activate to get the notifications. Click on the little icon down below. Make sure you get all of our notifications. So we're going to be talking about this letter of recommendation right after this. All right, letter of recommendation. The biggest problem that foreign trained dentists have when they're applying to schools in the United States is that the system, the application system, is very, very, very different here. I'm going to use Brazil as a comparison. Like in Brazil, you go, you take their exam. If you get a good grade, you're in. If you don't, you're out. In the United States, you have a whole application process where passing the exam is just part of your application. There's so many other things that you have to get going in order to apply to the school to be considered for a position as a student. And one of these things is called letter of recommendation. And most of schools will require 3 letters of recommendation to be written on your behalf from somebody else. Who's going to write the letter? That's not the point of this video today. But my point is many, many doctors or professors from all over the world who never stepped a foot in the United States, they have never had to do this before. Because wherever they are, in the country that they are, writing letters of recommendation usually is not a requirement. So you're going to go to Professor Bob or Professor Mary or whoever is your professor in your school, and you're going to be like, hey, I'm applying to this dental program and I need a letter of recommendation. We worked together for the last 10 years, 5 years, 3 years, whatever that is. Would you mind writing me a letter on my behalf to explain why I'm a good candidate for that school? And of course, your professor is going to say, yes, absolutely, I'll write that letter. However, I have no clue what to write. That's basically what people say. And or they might not say anything. They just may write the letter for you without saying anything. But the letter is not good. Not good. I have revealed, I don't know how many, but lots of letters of recommendation in the past, and people ask my opinion about it. And I basically gonna tell you the main mistake that I see people doing when they're writing a letter of recommendation. The main mistake is what I call the generic letter. You should avoid writing a generic letter. What is a generic letter, Leo? Can you go into detail and explain what does that mean? Yes, I can. Let's do that. So a generic letter is a letter where your professor is going to write. And in this letter, whatever he or she says, if they take your name out of the letter and put somebody else's name into that letter continues to be true. But what do you mean by that? Well, let me explain to you. Bob, let's say your name is Bob. Bob was a great student. I really enjoyed working with him. He was fantastic. Let's take the name Bob out of the letter. Let's put Mary. Mary was a great student. I really enjoyed working with her. She was fantastic. Well, for both names, the letter continues to be true. Let's put Alfred. Alfred was a great student. I really enjoyed working with him. He was fantastic. It could also be a true letter. Okay? So no matter what name you put into that letter, if you just change the name, the letter continues to be true. That's what I call a generic letter. It doesn't help you, really. Okay? Now, if you say, Bob's a great student, he was my right-hand person on my research lab where he worked for 3 months. Now, you take the name Bob out and you put Mary. Is that true for Mary? Probably not, because Mary did something else. Okay, does that make sense? You're following the line of thought here? So when you start to be specific about what a person does and you replace that person's name with somebody else's name, that letter is not true anymore, okay? So the generic letter does not help you. Does not help you. And I have so many letters that I received where people write a whole paragraph of just stuff that is generic. He was a great student. He was really nice. He treated patients really well. Well, that's true for the vast majority of people out there, you know? So that doesn't stand out. So what you want to do is be specific in this letter of recommendation. The more specific, the better, because it becomes more personal, okay? You definitely don't want to have a letter of recommendation where ChatGPT or whatever can write it for you, because that's going to be a generic letter. It's not going to be unique. It's not going to be personal. So make sure you avoid this mistake about doing a letter of recommendation that's generic. So whenever your professor comes to you and say, hey, what should I write in this letter of recommendation? You have two options. If you're signed up in my course, you can let your professor watch my lecture about the letter of recommendation, which is great, it's complete, has all the details, or you can refer him or her to this video so at least they know to not write a generic letter of recommendation. Hope you like the video. Sign up, subscribe, share with your friends, leave a comment, and bring up some ideas for new content, and I'm going to be here sharing new information with you at Dental Academy USA.